Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets and you have a table of data, so that's what we have right here, and it has different background fill colors in it, and you're trying to either count or sum the amounts of each background color. Okay, so if you come in here, let's say you want to grab count of the total number of cells that have a background color of green. Let's hold down the control key and then click to select all of the cells with the background color of green. And we'll go to the bottom right-hand corner. So there's kind of a shortcut here. It always shows you the sum of the cells that you have selected. And if you left-click on it, it will show you some other functions as well. So what we're trying to replicate with this function is the count. So you see it's saying there's 8 of them. And if I look at my formula here, it's returning an 8. So that's a little short proof that these functions are working and how they're working. So these are custom functions. If you look, this one's called sum colored cells, and this one's called count colored cells. The same function in these cells, but an important thing to note here is that the function sum colored cells doesn't exist in Google Sheets. That's not a standard function, so that was written specifically for this spreadsheet. I contacted a friend that I know called Brian Wokley, and he created 2 custom functions for us. In the spreadsheet that you copy, we'll also have these, but we'll take a look at them if you go up to Tools and left-click on Script Editor. What Brian did was define how count colored cells works and how sum colored cells worked, and those are automatically associated with this spreadsheet. So you don't have to write those. They're going to come with the spreadsheet, but if you want to look through them and understand them, you can look there. And the link to the spreadsheet will be in the description of the video. I have a link to Brian's YouTube channel in the description of this video and in the spreadsheet if you want to check him out. He knows how to write AppScript. I don't. Works well. So if you come back and you want to use this spreadsheet with your own data, the first thing that you want to do is replace this table with yours. And you might have to move some things around in the spreadsheet to accommodate for it because it's not going to be the same size. And once you do that, we're going to talk about what you need to adjust. The first thing is the data range. So this cell kind of made it obvious that you need to update this input if you update this range of cells. So type the new range into F7, and then let's look at these functions. Both of them work the same, so we'll just look at the function in B20. I'll double left click in it. Sum colored cells, the first thing that it wants to do is take the range. So it's looking at F7, so we've updated that already. And then it wants the color. And the color is just what you've colored B20. So you'll notice that each of these functions is colored, which corresponds to the color that it's summing or counting. You need to make these colors match these colors. We'll talk about the format painter in 1 second. So you make sure you're grabbing the exact color that you want. And the last parameter is that it's looking at F8. We'll talk about why it's looking at F8 is that there's a similar video to this that I made a few years ago. It got pretty popular and I got a lot of viewer comments and people are asking if you could make it count for multiple colors. So that's why we've expanded this area down here and it doesn't update. So we made this checkbox here. If you uncheck it and then check it again, your spreadsheet will update. So that kind of gives you a little hack to get this to update. And that's why it's always helpful if you have questions on these, post them in the comments on YouTube. And if I get enough comments asking certain things, I'll just make new videos based on your feedback. So I love it. Keep it coming. The third step that I explained here is what we just went over. It's to update these colors to correspond to what you want. But to make sure that you get the right color, you want to left click on Paint Format, and then that will bring down the exact color to the cell in C20. Now you do have to be careful using the format painter, and this is actually a good example of why I usually don't use cell borders, because you can't paste only the background color. It's also going to bring in the borders. So let's just quickly go back into C20 and fix that. Cell borders look nice, but a lot of times they just add extra time having to maintain them. And then the last step, which we also went over, is just to toggle the checkbox. So if you change anything in here, just take the checkbox, uncheck it and recheck it. So let's test one. We have green instead of 1, I'm going to make it 5. So keep your eye on the totals. This is 66. Let's move the checkbox on and off and it updates to 70. I'll just do one thing here. I'm going to change color totals to color sum to differentiate it from count. And since we always use the proper format for Google Sheets, we'll make these function names uppercase. Nothing like correcting it on the fly, right? So in our next video, we're going to talk about how to make an interactive checklist in Google Sheets. When you check something off, it puts a strike through your to-dos. Thanks for watching.